Here are 10 things to know about the shell command. If you need to shell the whole body, you can select the body from the bodies folder. Or you can hover the cursor over an edge until the whole body gets highlighted and make the selection. By selecting different faces, you can control which faces to open. If a thickness value has been entered, hold down Ctrl to add faces. You can even create a box with a shell that goes all the way through. To control the size and shape of the openings of a box, consider using split faces to define these openings. With this sketch, go to Modify, Split Face. Select this as a face to split and select the sketch as a splitting tool. Create another split face on this face. In the shell command, make sure to uncheck the tangent chain option and select these two split faces. Set the thickness. Fusion recognizes that you are trying to create a hollow box with these two openings. Fillets should be created before shelling, so that the shelling can take care of internal corners. Take note that in this case, if the shell thickness is equal to or exceeds that of the fillet radius, the shell will still create a sharp edge. There are certain situations that call for shelling on opposite sides. In this case, we have the shelling of the main body on one side and a small section which is shelled on the reverse side. In this case, create the main body and shell that first. Next, create the protrusion as an extrude. Start the shell command. Select these two faces to shell. This works well only if both the shell thicknesses are the same, or if the shell thickness of the smaller section is larger than the main shell thickness. In an extension of the previous point, what if we need to shell this with a smaller thickness than the main body? If we do that, it will affect the thickness of the main body. To resolve that, we need to isolate this section by splitting it out. First, we need to create a cutting tool. Activate the Surface tab. Go to Create, Offset. Select these faces. Set the offset to 0 and confirm. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the solid body as a body to split. Select the surface body as a splitting tool. Extend the splitting tool to cut through the whole body. This is the section that has been split out. Activate the solid tab and perform the shell on this section. Combine the two bodies. The shell command can be a viable way of creating frame-like structures. This can be done by performing the shell in stages. In this case, I will use the first shell to establish the open faces. For the next shell operation, let's open up the side faces. Perform another shell operation on the top. This is a pretty robust workflow, as it responds very well to changes. Shells are commonly performed by coring out the inside, but you can do it on the outside as well by changing the direction option. Consider using the shell command to make an external skin for a body. First, make a copy of the original body by selecting the body in the bodies folder and pressing Ctrl-C and Ctrl-V. Click OK to accept the copy in the same position as the original. Hide one of the bodies. Perform a shell on the other body. With the direction set to outside. Unhide the other body. Besides inside and outside, the shell can be performed in both directions. Each direction can be controlled with a different thickness.